This is just one of the basic tumbaos that you can utilize two drums with. There are many others, variations, etc., but this is the basic one. So if you know this from the first video, one, two, three, four. It should be easy for you to come up with the hand movement for utilizing the second drum. So with the second drum, as you noticed, hits with the three side of the clave. It aligns with that, okay? In other words, here's the three side of the clave, of the son clave. One, two, and three, four. That's the three side, the three notes. One, two, and three, four. So the tumbao fits like this. Again. 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 Okay, so the movement is palm, tip, slap, just like in the tumbao one drum, okay? Again, palm, tip, slap. And then on the end of two and three, you hit the second drum. One and two and three, again. One and two and three, again. One and two and three. And then the end of three, the tip of the fingers, and then four and the two open tones. So again, one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. So I'm just playing it over and over again so you can get the movement. So now we're playing neutral. This type of neutral pattern, using the drum over and over again, every bar, you can utilize it, for example, like for the cha-cha-cha. Carlos Patato Valdez, when he played cha-cha-cha, he would always play like that. The great Cuban drummer who I worked with many years in Mario Bazar's Afro-Cuban Jazz Orchestra when I was the drummer with them. So again, I'm just doing the movement over and over again so you can cop it, right? One and two and three and four and one. Combining that with the tumbao on one drum with two open tones, we can outline the clave. So once we do that first bar, then we can go back to the tumbao I showed you in the first video. One and two and three and four. We put them both together and we're outlining 3-2 clave. One and two and three and four and. So now if we want to do 2-3 clave in that direction, say the arrangement starts like that, we reverse the pattern. We start with the tumbao with two open tones on one drum, followed by the tumbao with, on the two drums on the three side. 2-3-4. Just to get you in the groove, clap with me. 1-2-3-4. 1-2-3. Four, one, two, three, four. What you can do also is when you do this, the three side. You can slap, if you want to, occasionally, on the end of three. One and two and three and four and give a little accent there. That was a technique that Frankie Malave, the great New York-based conga drummer of Puerto Rican descent, used to do a lot when he used to play tumbao. So it would sound like this with enclave in 2-3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, some of the players that you can listen to that will really give you a good example in terms of playing these basic tumbaos really in the pocket and in the context of a band, in the context of a salsa orchestra playing in a band context, are Papo Pepin, the great Puerto Rican conga drummer, and Eddie Montalvo, the great Puerto Rican conga drummer, who are both based here in New York City. So I would encourage you, if you live in the city, to go check them out when they're playing around town. There are many other great players, but those guys have set a standard that we all admire and look up to. And also another person who's mostly known as virtuosic bongo player, bongocero, Johnny Rodriguez, who is probably the most recorded conga drummer in the history of all of salsa because of the length of time he's been on this planet, but also because his tumbao is so nasty when he plays, going back all the way to the early 60s up until now. As I said before, he's mostly known as a virtuosic bongo player, but Johnny's a great, great conga player also. So those three guys that I mentioned right now, Papo Pepin, Eddie Montalvo, and Johnny Rodriguez, will give you a good idea of what this is supposed to sound like in the context of a salsa orchestra. The fact that they play Afro-Cuban music, and they're not Cuban, they're New York Puerto Ricanos, is a testament to what the great Machito, the great Cuban band leader, the Machito Afro-Cubans, the great vocalist Machito, who this band was the first to fuse jazz and Afro-Cuban music. Not Dizzy Gillespie. Dizzy would always say, I didn't do it first, it was them. Machito always used to say, si quieres que toque la música cubana bien, búscate un puertorriqueño de Nueva York. If you want somebody to play Cuban music for you well, find yourself a Puerto Rican from New York. For Jazz at Lincoln Center, I'm Bobby Sanabria. See you sooner than later.